John Carter, we're in, we actually are in Los Angeles at a place called Catalina, the Bar and Grill. I haven't played here in a very long time. I was supposed to play last year, but I had some serious back issues. And I had to cancel the tour because I just couldn't, not just travel this far, I just couldn't travel a block, let alone to travel and make a concert with Donald Vega on piano and Los Malone on guitar. So I'm glad we're here to kind of erase that canceled visit. Someone asked me yesterday why I keep doing this, and a real simple answer is that this is what I do. One of the things I look for, and I kind of feel comfortable to include Donald and Russell in this paragraph, we're looking for a chance where we can get to another level. And we can't do that if we're in our house or if we're just not performing. We hear ideas all the time in our head. We try to find a place that fits this idea in music. One of the things people always ask is, what were you doing, what would you do if you weren't doing this? And I've been so consumed with these possibilities of doing what I do to spend the effort to find out alternatively what I would want to do if I were in another position or if I had different options, would I get involved in those options? The answer is always no. The creators decided that I'm going to do this. And for me to spend the time to figure out what an alternative living job would be or a different occupation would be, it just seems to like a waste of time, time not well spent. We're here at Catalina's in California, July 24, 25, and 26. We're playing two shows a night. I've prescribed the set for the week. I've written out the program so that they know what's coming, and the surprises will be not what song it is, what they manage to do with it night in and night out. Stick around and see what happens.
My name is Donald Vega, and I play piano. I've been playing with Maestro Ron Carter for 2 years, and I mean, it's very hard to really describe the importance of just getting schooled by a master. I mean, Ron Carter is a legend. We were just talking about all the he's been recording for 55 years. He's all if you look at all the important records, he's on them, it's very hard, to not find him. He's always on, history. But most importantly, learning by his example, how he lives his life, he's a very honest person. And of course, he brings all the experiences, to the band, and I learned from him all of that, and continue to do so. It's an honor, and it's a privilege to be able to learn from him and play with him.
My name is Russell Malone. I play the guitar. I've been playing since I was 4 years old. I've been playing with Ron Carter. He started calling me for gigs back in 1995. First time we played together was on the set of a Robert Altman movie, a movie called Kansas City. And I'll never forget, we were we had gathered to, you know, talk about the movie and what our roles would be in the movie, you know, who would play on this tune or who would play on that tune. And, you know, Ron Carter is a very stoic, imposing figure of a man, very no-nonsense, old school, no-nonsense. So everybody was watching and looking at him, and they wanted to go up to him and say hello or say something to him, because he's our hero. You know, we all grew up listening to his records. So all the other musicians, they wanted to approach him, but they didn't quite know how. So I said, well, the heck with it, I'm gonna go up to him. So I walked up to him and I said, Mr. Carter, you are my hero. All of the records that I listened to when I first got into jazz music, you are the bass player on those records, and you're on my list of musicians to play with. And without missing a beat, with that quick wit of his, he said, well, you know, give me a call sometime and get me off your list. just like that. And we hit it off. So he started to call me for gigs after that. In fact, the first actual gig I did with Ron Carter was at the Museum of Modern Art. And it was with him, Kenny Barron, Jesse Davis was playing alto, and Louis Nash was on drums. And it was just, you know, it's one thing to hear that sound on record, but it's something else altogether when you are experiencing that in real time. Because, you know, it's fun. It's funny, you get one perspective when you hear the records, but imagine going to the zoo, okay? You're standing on this side of the cage, looking at the lion, right? You have the barrier, the fence between you and the lion. Now, that's one perspective. Now, imagine yourself on the other side of the cage with the lion. It looks a little bigger. You can hear it breathing, you can hear it purring, you're standing right next to it, and you know that at any given moment, it could really do some damage. Well, that's what it's like playing with Ron Carter. You know, it's, and you can't listen to him on a superficial level. One of the things that I've gotten from playing with him, playing with the bass, with a bass player like that, is that you have to listen. Because we had a conversation about listening one time, and he told me that one of the things that made that band with Miles Davis, Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter, Tony Williams, and himself, one of the things that made that band so special was the fact that everybody trusted each other. You had this high-level musicianship on the bandstand. Then you had the element of trust. And when you have that, and then listening, because he's really big on listening too, so when you got great musicianship, the level of trust, and then everybody listening to each other, you don't have to make anything happen. Everything will take care of itself. And that's what I got from playing with him. You know, you listen to him, and people say, man, it must be a challenge playing with Ron Carter. And I really hate that word challenge in connection to music. I see it as being engaged, you know, because sometimes if you're met with a challenge, there may be some resistance. I don't, you know, that doesn't belong in music. We're not up there boxing or fighting. It's not athletics. It's not sport. It's music. And it's about being engaged. So, it's great to be able to play with him. When I first got into the music, I was listening to those records by George Benson and Wes Montgomery, and Ron Carter was on those records. And I was listening to those guys play the guitar because those were, you know, that's my instrument. But the bass player, his personality was so strong. Not only was I listening to those guitar players, but my attention shifted to him because some of the things that he was doing on those records was just so, you know, just so marvelous and beautiful. And the Miles Davis records, when I think the first record that I bought by Miles Davis was Live at the Plug Nickel. You know that record, Donald, Live at the Plug Nickel. And, you know, at the time, me being so young and naive, I was thinking about all of those beautiful, weird harmonic things that Herbie Hancock was playing. And I'm like, man, this piano player is really out there, man. But as I started to play with Ron Carter, it dawned on me, wait a minute, I think he may have been the catalyst for where a lot of that music went harmonically, because we're on the bandstand and every night it's always something different. You never know what the hell he's gonna play. And you have to be on your P's and Q's. So I really think that he instigated a lot of that, the direction, the harmonic direction in the band with Miles Davis. I really do believe that, because, you know, playing with him, you know, you just never know what's gonna happen. And you can't rely on things that you played in the practice room. You have to be in the moment and you have to listen. And that's what the music is about anyway, you know, being in the moment, not playing it safe and relying on things that you played in the practice room.